was your most memorable part of filming?
To be honest, probably the moment I stepped on set for the first time, because, I mean, you probably have that answer from everyone, but it really was. I play someone who exists over hundreds of years. So when I first walked into the first of our sets that was a pub in 1389, it looked, felt, smelled real, and I saw Tom and Kirby in costume for the first time, and myself in costume for the first time, and I thought, I think we're doing Sandman. Although they'd been filming for months and months and months, so I was quite a latecomer. But for me, I sort of in that moment when, yeah, this is happening, this is real. Tom is what I would want to be if I were ever given the responsibility or the chance to be a number one on a show. He's completely devoted to, is he just there? He's completely devoted to it. He takes it seriously, but not himself. He, you know, he's the person that when we were rehearsing said, you know, if we have to get up at 4 a.m. and come in to rehearse something, then I'll do that. And also because our dynamic on the show is basically two people gradually getting to know each other, it kind of felt like that. When we weren't shooting, we were sitting where we were when we were shooting, sitting on the same seats, working out how to be pals with each other. I think he's absolutely ace. I think he is basically all you could dream of, to play Dream. And it was, if you're going to have a part where you basically interact with one person, he's a good one to interact with.
Of course, your character asks the audience a central question, is immortality worth having? Your character has a very enthusiastic response to that. Do you share that enthusiasm?
Not fully. I share his enthusiasm for going at life full throttle. I hope so. In theory, I do anyway. Probably in life, I go in about second gear. But I think probably after a couple of hundred years, I'd probably want to exercise my release clause.
And obviously, this is based on work by one of the most visionary and celebrated creatives in Neil Gaiman. Can you talk about what is so unique and special about his vision?
Yeah, I think Neil's writing is completely fearless, and it's unashamed, and it's not scared to... Well, I'm using synonyms, basically, but he's not afraid to take the biggest concepts in all his writing and throw them into completely potentially domestic circumstances, and see what comes out. And I think that's what makes him completely special, is that there's no attempt by him to dumb anything down. There's no attempt to take the sort of, as you say, the high philosophy out of stuff. But I think he's the master of the what if. He's the master of taking something huge and saying, what if it was happening in front of you? What would you do?
Of course, there's a huge amount of source material. If we do get a second season of Beyond, is there things that you're excited about getting to explore, both for your character and for the show as a whole?
Yeah, I mean, there's so much. And if I have the privilege to stick around, and we have the privilege to stick around, if I get to do Hobbes Leviathan, I'll be a happy man. Yeah, when Hobbes at sea for a whole issue. I think it's just a wonderful, beautiful episode in itself anyway, but also I'd like to be on a boat.